Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to discuss a demonstration of love. Demonstration of love. Amen. What do you think of, you know, people just protesting, having a demonstration with the signs, love and peace signs and everything?
Not in this case.
That's right. Not in this case.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, and let's just pray. We're going to just really pray that you will receive God's word, and this will fall on good ground in each and every person that is watching and each person that are listening to us via podcast. Father, we thank you so very much, and we praise your holy name. We give you all the glory and all the praise and all the honor, Lord. We give you all the hallelujahs, because you are worthy of all the praise, God. We enter your gates with thanksgiving and your courts with praise, for you are God and God alone. We love you, Lord, and we thank you so very much. God, we thank you so very much for this opportunity. God, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for, oh God, we ask you to forgive us of our sins and to cover us with your precious blood. God, I thank you in the name of Jesus Christ for your grace and your mercy, for you are truly, oh God, a God, oh Lord, that treats us not the way we deserve. We thank you so much for your demonstration of love, so much, oh God, that you love us, that you died for us, you rose from the dead for us. God, you have continuously treated us, as I said before, Lord, you don't treat us the way we deserve, and we so appreciate you, and we want to thank you, Lord. Now let this word fall on good godly ground in every single person's life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm Pastor Natalie.
I'm Pastor Chris.
Yes. Thank you so much for joining us once again for all our episodes. Thank you for continuously tuning in.
Yes.
If you guys can turn to John 8.
Yes.
John chapter 8, verses 1 to 11. It's we're going to be talking about the woman that was caught in adultery. And there's really some important points that we really want to bring out here. So just follow along, okay? And while we're reading and while we're discussing today, mm-hmm. if you all have comments or anything, please comment on our section there on the bottom there where you're seeing you can make comments and chat with us and talk to us, okay? We love to get feedback. So John 8, verses 1 to 11 tells us, but Jesus went to the Mount of Olives, okay? Early in the morning, verse 2, he went back into the temple courts. All the people came to him, and he sat down to teach them. So he had a crowd. Verse 3, the scribes and Pharisees, however, brought to him a woman caught in adultery. Mm. Hold on. They made her stand before them, and he said, teacher, this woman was caught in the act of adultery. In the law of Moses commanded us to stone such a woman. So what do you say? Let me just say this first, before I know Pastor Chris is going to say some stuff. First of all, what were these scribes and Pharisees doing watching a woman having an adulterous relationship with someone? That's first of all. Looking at that, they were already in sin watching that.
Okay.
That's just first of all. Okay.
Never thought about that part.
Second of all, they only brought the woman. Only the woman is mentioned. Where's the man?
That part made me scratch my head every single time. I'm like, you know, doesn't it make two?
It takes two to tango.
Exactly. where's the dude? Where is he?
Where is he?
You know,
he's not talked about, right?
And
so what are they doing? They're trying to bring shame to this woman.
Correct.
Right?
They're trying to trap her, and they're trying to trap Jesus.
Yeah.
Basically. And then just before we even go any further, you know, I myself had to find out. I'm sure, you know, they say in the book of Moses and everything. So I just to reference it, guys, turn to, you know, yourselves at another time, Leviticus 20, verse 10.
That's
it clearly
a reference.
This is a reference that you know, a man who does adultery also should be, you know, killed or stoned. And just, you know, Deuteronomy 5:18, it just says, do not commit. Mm-hmm. It doesn't say women don't commit only, and
it's
you're
going to
be stoned. It's both.
Yes.
And, you know, there's some other quotes, but there's just two of them that I found. And I said, wow, mm-hmm. that is interesting.
So what were they doing? They're trying to judge.
Correct.
and condemn her.
That they certainly were. And what they didn't realize, even in doing that, ladies and gentlemen, they were, yes, the scribes and the Pharisees of that day. And we're not, you know, we're going to be very honest with you. You know, we can go in many directions,
oh, yeah.
many directions. But we just want to let you guys know that, you know, when we're going to stick to the demonstration of love for this specific episode. And you know, in seeing this, the scribes and the Pharisees, what they didn't even realize, because, you know, the next couple of verses you'll see is that they were literally being self-righteous and they weren't even realizing that they were.
Mm-hmm.
And in a way, because mm-hmm. they were doing it not with the pure heart.
Mm-hmm.
They weren't doing it mm-hmm. to as we will continue in a literally a demonstration of how Jesus didn't condemn. So I'm not going to jump ahead of us. But we're going to go ahead and read the scriptures.
So the other part is mm-hmm. when you bring someone to Jesus, you're bringing someone to Jesus out of love.
Yes.
If you bring anybody to Jesus or you give anybody Jesus, so to speak, you're talking to them about Jesus and you're talking to them like the way this was presented.
Yeah.
You're not demonstrating the love of God.
Correct. Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
And you're going to see why we're going here, right? So verse six, they said this to what? Test him.
Wow.
In order to have a basis for what? Accusing him now. So not only were they trying to accuse her, they wanted to accuse him.
Exactly what I said. They were trying to trap her,
right?
And they were trying to trap Jesus.
So this is awesome, though. Follow us. But Jesus bent down and he began to write on the ground with his finger. No one knows for sure what
Correct.
Jesus was writing, but he was writing.
Correct.
That's why it's mentioned here.
Before you go any further, how many of you, and I pray that you guys have not done this specific first thing, but the second thing, you've probably heard, some of you are like, oh, you know what? Here comes this pastor. Here comes this person. I want to get them, and I'll come and say something just to see. That's the same situation. You're trying to be self-righteous, trying to be not being and having an accusatory heart instead of saying, hey, let me just see what they feel about something. We can have a conversation about it, but not like, rrr. The second thing is that I know I've certainly encountered it. People have literally come and said, that person. Mm-hmm. They've literally brought in a situation to me just hoping for something negative to talk about.
Mm-hmm. Like to catch you off guard.
Catch me off guard or something else.
Get
and
you
I'm thinking to
up
myself, there's so much good that we could be talking about. That yes, we always acknowledge what's wrong, but God is a God that loves and delights in what's taken wrong and making it right.
Which is what we're going to see here.
The demonstration of love.
Yes. So they, in verse 7 says, when they continued to question him, so they were becoming annoying,
yes.
right? He straightened up and he said to them, let him who is without sin among you be the first to cast a stone at her. And again, he bent down and he wrote on the ground. Again, we do not know what he's writing, but it is said for a purpose. Because, you know, when I look at this, I think to myself, how many of us, we're so fault-finding, we are so ready to throw stones, so to speak, and speak maliciously about others.
Correct.
But what is so awesome here is that Jesus is saying, why don't you take a moment and examine yourself? Are you all that in a bag of chips? Remember what I said. These guys were watching her and this other person in this relationship being intimate like that. So they immediately grabbed her. They didn't grab him. It doesn't mention there. So they were already sinning themselves, right?
Because they weren't doing what the full law said first and foremost. But also they came to accuse.
Yes.
And that is a wrong way. Because even if ourselves as pastors, now as we're discussing it, we're telling you what the scripture is saying, what took place,
Correct.
Which was the truth. But we're going to be concerned about how we are, even as we are discussing
Absolutely.
This. Because we're not considering ourselves better than these scribes
Absolutely.
And these Pharisees.
No.
But we're also going to check our hearts as we
That's
deliver this word.
It's part of the lesson.
Demonstration
Amen.
Of love.
Yes. Right. Amen. Yes. So we're going to jump now to verse 9. When they heard this,
mm-hmm.
right? Remember what he just finished saying. Let him who is without sin among you be the first to cast a stone. In other words, how about you check yourself?
Yes.
Check your heart out.
Like before we take communion.
Yes.
You examine yourself.
Yes. And when they heard this, they began to go away one by one, beginning with the older ones, until only Jesus was left with the woman standing there. Okay. So we see here this demonstration of love. Because what the Lord did in this moment, the Lord Jesus Christ, is he covered her.
Yes.
You see, what they were doing, when people are calling out sin like this, they're doing it in a manner to shame the person.
Right.
Right? They're doing it in a manner to bring condemnation.
Correct.
Right? And a guilt. See, the Lord Jesus Christ will convict us of sin. That's why every single one of them had to put the stone down. They themselves knew. They all became convicted because they knew not one of them there was without sin.
Correct.
Right? So it started from the oldest to the youngest, right? So then you see her left. What the devil meant for bad. See, what the enemy meant for harm.
Yes.
This woman got saved that day. She got saved.
It's amazing.
Because, see, they thought she was going to be dead in her sins. They thought she would die that day. See, they were ready to do that. But Jesus saved her that day. And that's what Jesus does for us. See, yes. Jesus doesn't come to us to condemn us.
No.
Jesus comes to us to save us.
For God so loved the world.
Yes. And he said, "Woman, where are your accusers? Has no one condemned you?" And her answer, and she said in verse 11, "No one, Lord." And this is his answer. And this is what he says to you and I.
That's right.
"Then neither do I condemn you." Okay? And now this is the part that's also important. Jesus says, "Now go and sin no more." In other words, he just covered her, loved her. He put away her shame, right? And he's telling her now, don't go back to that now. Don't go back to the very thing that shamed you.
That's right.
That caused you to feel separated from what you're experiencing right now, love.
It's almost like, in a sense, it's almost like don't go back to those things, sinful things, but go towards something good that can possibly help you. If there's any one of our listeners or our viewers right now,
yes,
that have actually said this, I say it's a crazy statement. Pastor Nelly and myself, I've heard this so many times.
Yeah.
You know what? I can't come to church. I got to get my life right first, and then I'm going to come to church. Ladies and gentlemen, pretend like this is a hospital right here, okay? And you have the flu or something else, and you whatever you can possibly have, and you know you need to just go to the emergency room. They'll give you, you know, work on you, clean you up, give you a medicine, or whatever they can point out to you to walk into a better direction just to help you out. But you're telling the hospital, "Oh no, I'm going to stay here. I've got to get kick this flu and stop everything. And when I'm good, oh, I don't have the flu anymore. A month later, I am good. I think I'm going to go to the emergency room and I'm going to go say hello to those doctors." How ridiculous is that?
Yeah.
So I want to tell you, the enemy's lies, just as you know, it's for you to be, for you to just to withdraw and be by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to be honest with you. I watch a lot of wild animal stuff. My family teases me all the time. "Oh, Dad is watching that animal shows again." Those animals that go by themselves, they're wide open for attack, for predators all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what the enemy wants. But when I think about what you said, this, "Neither do I condemn you."
That's right.
"Neither do I condemn you."
Love covers.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're feeling all by alone and you feel sinful and everything, and you've been telling yourself, "No, I'm not going to go to church. I'm not going to go talk to that person or something." I'm going to tell you, neither do we condemn you. Jesus Christ doesn't condemn you. He wants you,
yep,
to come to him.
Just as you are.
Don't be like that, yes, ridiculous, crazy situation, which I know I've heard. Oh, I can't come to church. I got to work my life right. It's like you telling the doctor, "No, I'm really deathly sick, but I'm not going to go. Let me just take care of myself. When I feel better, I'll come by and say hello to you." That doesn't make sense.
And the other part about this in Romans 8:1, when he told her, neither do I condemn you, Romans 8:1 now is a promise that continues from that statement that he said for every believer. It tells us, so now there is no condemnation for those who belong in Christ Jesus. So now there is no condemnation
yes.
for those who belong to Christ Jesus. And let me tell you something. If there's an opportunity for you to do good and to help someone who you see sinning, like how I said earlier, you see someone hurting themselves, someone doing something that is just not good for them. Don't go to them and make them feel guilty. Go to them and love them the way Jesus demonstrated the love that he showed to this woman.
Correct.
And it's not because she deserved it.
Right.
Just as they all walked away, she could have herself said, look, I don't deserve this either. And now that there's nobody else, I'm going to just walk away.
He said, right? Go sin no more.
Correct.
See, we're not trying to say that some people are to the point that I've heard the terminology, oh, you stop judging me. That's
not what we're talking about.
We're not talking about it.
No.
Exactly. And we don't want people to go into the opposite side and says, oh, I'll just accept anything. Don't judge me.
No, I won't judge
you or something. We're not talking about that, as we said. We're talking about the demonstration of love. That may be another Be Resplendent episode. But I'm going to be honest with you. As Pastor Nally's touching on, we're going to go to Galatians 6, verse 1. It clearly says this. Dear brothers and sisters, if another believer is overcome by sin, you who are godly should gently and humbly help that person back onto the right path. Mm-hmm. And be careful not to fall into the same temptation yourself. Mm-hmm. So as you're helping someone, you don't go and accuse a turvy. You're going to help them. And while you're helping them, you're saying, oh, but for the grace of God, you know, I'm not looking down at you. I'm here to help you because I can fall too. But I'm not going to concentrate on that. Let's work on restoring you in Jesus' name.
And that's the part, as we're going to get ready to pray here, that verse that you just read is pertaining to the body of Christ.
Correct.
When we see our brothers and sisters that they've fallen away, that they've been overcome by a sin or doing something that is opposing to what the Lord's will is in their life, and you're to go to them and encourage them and strengthen them. And it's not to just say, hey, you know better. No, you love them, because the same way you would want someone to do that for you. These Pharisees that knew the law, right? They needed to speak love over this woman, just as God wants us who know the word of God to speak God's love to others.
That scripture,
right?
Galatians 6:10 says, therefore, whenever we have the opportunity, we should do good to everyone, especially to those in the family of faith.
Yep.
Father God, I thank you so very much for this time. And I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you, Lord, will demonstrate your love continuously. And I know that you are to all of our listeners
yes.
and our viewers.
Encourage
but God, let
them today.
Open up their hearts and their minds
Jesus.
And say, God, whether it's healing I need, whether it's mental, whether it's the way I speak, I need to be changed. God, I'm opening up. I want you to, oh Lord, demonstrate your love, God. I'm open to you. And I ask you to forgive me of my sins, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Boy, we went through a lot, and we would love to spend so much more time with you. We look forward to the next Be Resplendent episode, just to share with you guys a strong word of God, because we want to disciple you.
Amen.
Connect with us. We want to walk you through the Bible personally, however you would like, in Jesus' name. We just want to bless you guys, for you guys to come visit us here at Resplendency, our prayer meetings, Bible studies, everything in Jesus' name. And don't forget to like it, share it in Jesus' name.
Subscribe
if you didn't, and read Pastor Natalie's blog.
Yes, I really thank each of you who continue to follow me at Examine Moments, and those that take time to read my blogs. I really thank you on letstakeamoment.com. And remember also, we have a new podcast. We have podcasts now. So make sure that you're listening to those two. We have a series of Resplendency Life, besides our Be Resplendent episodes.
That's
also
right.
On our podcast.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Jesus Christ, I want you just to live according to this
yes.
word. And as you do
Amen.
This, do you know what will happen in your life?
Amen.
This
yes.
is our motto,
true,
but we encourage you to do this for Jesus Christ.
Stand out and shine.
God bless you.
Amen. We love you.